Hello and welcome to Office Hours. I am Greg Yachtman from Celona. Joining me is Mehmet Yavuz, as always, and we have one of our favorite guests back, Srini. So between the three of us, we're going to talk about something that we started heading towards with system identifiers in episode 10. Today, we're finally getting to the place that I wanted to get around SIMs. We've had a lot of questions on our webinars around what is a SIM or how does a SIM work with CBRS. Today, we're going to get that answer. So Srini, Mehmet, let's get into the 101 of SIMs.
Thanks, Greg. Hi, everyone. Maybe I'll just jump in first. First of all, SIM. SIM stands for Subscriber Identity Module or Subscriber Identification Module. And as we know, there are all these devices in the CBRS band available now. They are being used in many different use cases in different enterprise verticals, for example, with our CBRS solution. And all of these devices connect securely to the CBRS LTE network. And this is managed by the SIM cards. And basically in that SIM card or module, what you have is some securely stored information, such as the mobile subscriber identity, like the IMSI number or some of the secure keys that are used in the authentication of the device. And all of these things get into the devices in a secure manner, either as a physical SIM card or as an embedded SIM, which is a secure environment inside the mobile device. And so that's how all the smartphones, handhelds, tablets, IoT devices, gateways, CPEs securely connect to the CBRS LTE network. Given that we have Srini today, maybe I'll let you talk about some of the details of these two types of SIM modules, Srini.
Good afternoon, Mehmet and Greg. Glad to be back on this channel here. Mehmet mentioned, yes, we have two different types of SIM provisioning platforms. One is a physical SIM and or an embedded SIM, which is there inside the memory of the device itself. So the profile information, typically what is referred to as all the credentials and all of the information which Mehmet referenced before, are all aspects of what is called as built into a SIM profile. The SIM profile has all the certificates required for authenticating itself. It has the IMSI, it has the system selection parameters, and numerous other tunable parameters in terms of scanning, looking for systems, and a bunch of other things which are there. So collectively, they are referenced as a SIM profile. That SIM profile is put into a physical SIM or put it into an embedded SIM. Physical SIM tends to be something that we ship or package it and ship it into the enterprise campus. And all the user has to do is plug it into a device there. For an embedded SIM, it has an added flexibility where the user can dynamically select, scan it through a camera, collect a QR code on that, and then look for the SIM credential to be pulled onto the device. Or additionally, an enterprise IT can actually use an MDM type of platform where the user is not involved at all, and they can actually provision the device with an enterprise credential.
Okay, so I'm with you so far. Maybe you could go one step further and tell me, how do we provision these SIMs? And remember, keep it simple. That's my little pun for the day.
That's a great pun there, I mean, Greg. So yeah, I think keeping it simple, there we have two GSMA models which are there. Typically what is called as a consumer model and an M2M or an IoT type of model meant for headless devices there. So if you're looking at a consumer model where that means the user is able to receive and provision the device. So now what you have is that I sort of referenced it earlier, what the enterprise IT can provide is a mechanism by which they can be provided with a QR code and the user scans that QR code and that profile is received using the generic GSMA platform, which we have. Celona has a generic GSMA platform that we have to actually point the user to a particular server through which the credential can be received. In addition, if it's an MDM, the profiles are pre-prepared and given to the enterprise IT, and the enterprise IT can put it onto the device there. Now, if you're looking at a physical SIM, like I said, these are pre-packaged and sent out to the site. So that means there is actually no real activity from a user end perspective other than just plugging it into the physical device itself.
I mean, we are all about removing frictions in the enterprise, right? Just trying to keep it simple and make it scalable and all those good things. So essentially, in one form, it is everything pre-provisioned before it is shipped to the enterprise, right? Just like we ship the APs, We ship a bunch of SIM cards. The IT can take those SIM cards and plug it into the cameras or IoT devices or any of the workforce devices. We also provide the ability to remotely provision SIMs, where they can leverage the kind of mechanism that they already use with Wi-Fi today, such as MDM. And that will enable them to remotely provision the SIM profile credentials into the embedded SIM in those end devices. So some models work better in certain scenarios than the others. And then the other interesting part is the QR code scanning. We'd love to talk about those details and follow up with anyone who's interested.
I know there's more to discuss. There's much more technical details and acronyms to go through. But for today, that answers my question. Hopefully it answers yours out there. Thank you both for the presentation. Thank you, those who are listening and watching. Please like, subscribe, share with your friends, your office mates, and make sure that you return to office hours or check out our old episodes, because it might just have the stuff you're looking for. If not, let us know what you are looking for and we'll cover it soon. In the meantime, thank you for watching and we'll speak to you soon. Have a great day.